The ocean. American politicians are still tussling over how to raise the country's debt ceiling. While Republicans and Democrats argue, Secretary of State Hillary Clinton has been trying to calm nervous Asian investors that they will meet next week's deadline. Well, let's talk to E. Michael Jones. He's the editor of the Catholic Current Affairs magazine. Thanks very much, Mr. Jones, for being on the program. Now, both the U.S. Secretary of State and the Treasury Secretary are confident that a compromise will be reached and that the debt ceiling will be raised. Now, are you convinced?
Yes, I think the debt ceiling will be raised. So there's good and bad news. The good news is there won't be a default, but the bad news that is on August 2nd, they'll be faced with the same problem they had on August 1st, and that is unrepayable debt. So how is the country going to deal with unrepayable debt? So they can postpone it, but they still have to deal with the same problem.
And just a quick question there. If you think it is going to be raised, why don't they just raise it now instead of having to wait for August 2nd or beyond that?
For political reasons. Each side, the Democrats and the Republicans, are trying to extort some type of political benefit out of the crisis. The Republicans want to cut welfare benefits, and the Democrats want to blame the whole thing on the Republicans. So it's basically political, a game of chicken. That's what we're seeing here, political game of chicken.
Okay, now Secretary of State Hillary Clinton is in Asia, and as I mentioned earlier, she has been trying to calm the jittery investors over there. So in this light, doesn't America have an obligation to other countries to sort out this mess? Because any U.S. default will have serious consequences elsewhere, and as we see, investors are already watching it very closely.
Yes, of course they have an obligation, but you can't do the impossible. And what we now are faced, what the United States is faced with, is an impossible situation, which means someone's going to end up with the money and someone's going to end up without any money. And so that's what's going to be worked out right now. Okay. What you have to realize is there are historical precedents for this. In the Middle Ages, if the prince didn't have his money, he simply defaulted on his loan, and because he had an army, and the bankers did not have armies. Over this period of time, the creditors have gained in power, and so it forces the government into another mode. The mode that was discovered at the beginning of capitalism was known as looting. Henry VIII was in the same position as the first English king. Instead of thumbing his nose at the bankers, he looted the church. He looted church property. And so I think what we're going to see now is the United States going into looting mode. This is what Libya, I think, is all about, the NATO operation in Libya.
Mr. Jones, you're very, very confident that they're going to raise the ceiling. You said that there has been precedents in the past. But when will it end, though? Will the U.S. just keep on raising their debt ceiling every time they're facing default?
Yes, they will continue to keep raising the debt ceiling.
And that's just going deeper and deeper into debt, isn't it?
Yes, because the rating agencies will lower their rating, which means they will have to pay more interest, which means that the interest will accumulate much faster. And so they will just go faster and faster into debt.
Okay, well, whatever is decided, but here you're saying that they will raise the ceiling. Who's going to pay off that massive debt?
No one's going to pay it off. It can't be paid off. So what they're going to do is try and arrange for month-to-month loans to pay off the last loan. There's no way to pay this debt off.
So what does that mean? The U.S. will just be perpetually in debt? That's it?
They will try to stay perpetually in debt, but I mean, at some point, then the agencies will stop lending the money. Their rating will disappear, and at that point, they will have to take some type of drastic action, which will be either more looting or, for example, looting pension funds is what they're doing right now, or they will simply have to create debase the currency to the point where they can pay it off with devalued dollars.
Okay, well, thank you very much for your insight there. Mr. E. Michael Jones, editor of a Catholic Current Affairs magazine, thank you.